Almighty God, you have blessed us with memory, reason, and skill. Help us to use them widely in the service of our town government. We ask this in thy holy name, amen. We salute the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America and to the republic which stands one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you all for coming. Anyone in the public wish to address the board? Okay, we're going to do things a little out of order tonight. I request, you got your post audit bills, and we need to pay the monthly bills early on. So, if you please review the bills. I would like a motion to approve the bills, if that's the desire of the board. Where are the monthly bills?
I'll make a motion to pay the monthly bills.
Do I have a second?
I'll second that.
Thank you. Any questions, concerns? Bills in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? That's carried. Want to hear that one now?
Yes.
Please. Do you have any others other than that one, Julie?
No, this is it.
Okay.
Water District Number 6, disbursement to room number 20. Town of Champlain legal notice, 103.35. Statewide Aqua Store, $297,136.25. Vernier and Carr, $23,298.50.
Okay. This bill has been submitted, if I'm correct, to the EFC, and they've been approved?
It will be submitted this week.
Okay.
And then they have to approve it in order to send you the money next week.
Okay. And thank you for sending us copies.
Yeah, it was a tight schedule last month. You know, our second Tuesday of the month was the 8th, which is the earliest it can be in the month. So by the time we get the bills from our sub-consultants, and then we can write up a bill and put it in the mail, we get it to you in advance.
We need a motion to approve, if that's the desire of the board. $297,000 is it yours? And we'll start with Vernier and Carr. $23,000. Any questions? I need a motion first, though.
So everybody understands what the billing process now. It sends to the EFC afterwards for approval before any money is dispersed. I think we had a question about that last meeting. But this is what we do, so everybody knows what's going on.
They submit it by the end of this week. The payment is the end of next week, if I'm correct.
Yeah, I think it hits your account before the end of next week.
And once the money's in the account, then we pay the bill.
Then you can cut the check, yeah.
I make a motion we pay the bill.
Okay. Do I have a second?
I'll second that.
Thank you. Any concerns, questions? No, this large.
I had a question for Anthony on one of the bills today, an add-on, but that was quite a while ago.
On statewide.
I guess it was an email on that.
Yeah, we got copies, so.
How did the accounts look overall for the project as far as where we are with the project? Are you guys keeping up with that?
Yep, I mean, the overall project budget right now still has just one placeholder left, and that's the water treatment plant. All the other budget line items are populated with actual cost with the bids that we've received. For the water plant, we have a placeholder of $2 million in the budget for it. And with that in the budget, we still have $400,000 in contingency. So hopefully that we get a good competitive number on the plant. We can hold that contingency, and then you can look at, perhaps start looking at your bid alternates as to which of those you'd like to award this year.
So the overall contingency remaining for the project is $400,000?
Correct.
That's the water plant.
Right.
Yeah. The plant comes in at 1.8. Your contingency grows to 600. Plant comes in at 2.2. the contingency drops to 200.
Earlier, you indicated that regarding that plant, that the plans either have been or soon be sent to the State Health Department?
Correct. They've been submitted to the State Health Department for approval.
But before they were sent down there, have all the people involved in actually working at that been involved in the design of it?
Yeah, Mike Jolliker's been closely involved with, and Greg, in reviewing those plans and making sure the plant configuration and size and the details are to their liking.
Well, let's not go that far, tonight.
Within what our budget can allow.
So once the Health Department signs off on it, there would not be changes in that plan?
We can make small, subtle changes that don't change the intent of the operation of the design. We move a door 4 feet to the left or something like that, wouldn't require us to go back to DOH.
Okay, this large amount of money, I believe we'll have a roll call vote. John?
Aye.
Brian?
Aye.
Clark?
Aye.
Stephen?
Aye.
Thank you, aye, please. Good luck.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming in, Jane, to do those. I believe we'll approve the minutes, then we'll get into Martin Carr's presentation. We need approval of the minutes. There was one change of one word spelling, that's all, it's amended on page 6, the big issue. I'd like a motion to approve the minutes as presented.
I'm going to motion to approve the minutes, with the amendment.
Thank you. Is there a second?
A second.
Thank you. Any questions? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? That's also carried. Matt, I think we'll go with you now. We've got several things to,
Sure.
Approve.
Yep. I've got some items both on water and sewer to go over. Maybe I'll start with sewer as those may be simpler to address first. One of the items we brought was the agreement with Department of State for the town to receive your $415,000 grant. They've sent the paperwork for that. We've reviewed it. Don't see any issue with that. Bill reviewed it, doesn't take any exception to it. So it awards you officially the $415,000 shared services grant for the West Service Road Sewer Project. DOT did confirm to me recently that they are 100% moving forward with theirs. The only thing left for them to sort out is the location that they're going to connect to Locust Street. But other than that, they plan on bidding it this fall and starting construction next spring. So in order to keep up with their schedule, we should probably get started with the district formation process for the West Service Road. That has to begin with a map plan and report that describes the service area, the cost, the ADUs, all of that. So we can get started on that, so that you have that to form the district. And I think Anthony mentioned email as well that, or I mentioned in the email perhaps, that if DOT is this far along in their design of their sewer, we should probably get started on our design because the couple have to marry up. And the manholes they're installing as part of theirs are the manholes we need to connect the service laterals into. So if we haven't determined the depth we need for those service laterals to be able to connect to the properties, we can't tell them how deep those manholes need to be. And if they have a manhole 6 foot deep, we need an 8 foot deep in order to service that building, we've got a big problem. So, and we'd like to start design on that. We can have the same arrangement we did on the water, where, you know, we can get started on design and, you know, you wouldn't have to make payment for any design until your funding is actually in hand and they start dispersing money. I just don't want DOT to put something out the bid that doesn't work well for your part of the project. But again, we can start at least with a map plan and report immediately so that you can start the district formation process in the coming months. Get that on schedule.
And the village is up to date on what's going on as far as hooking up. I mean, we haven't gotten very far in the DOT, but either one of the options where it hooks in or what was, we don't really have a say in that.
Not necessarily. I mean, DOT is calling the shots at this point, and actually internally they haven't agreed as to where they want to place the line. So
it'll work, but I don't. It'll work hooking up with the village, all right.
So, and I emailed all of you the draft agreement that DOT has put together. That doesn't require you to take action yet. They just wanted you to see the draft and make sure it's acceptable for you, so that, you know, when the time comes, you can execute that, and they will turn over their infrastructure to you. For the sewer project, when we started the funding application process, you were required to have an engineering agreement to satisfy the requirements of the funding agency. At that time, we drafted an agreement for you for a larger $6 million project, which included sewer all the way down Route 11 toward Rouse's Point. We're not doing all that at this point, so we've got an amendment to that agreement to scale up our services down to just the West Service Road piece. So I've got those tonight. It's an amendment to the contract you had already approved to reduce our services to just the West Service Road. Scales our design fee down, our fee on everything down, just for that one part. So I've got that for your consideration tonight for approval. And that's part of what Anthony has emailed to you in the past week to review. So on the sewer, I think that pretty much covers the status of everything. With the only two action items being executing the agreement with Department of State for the grant and the amendment to our agreement to reduce our fees to just the West Service Road portion.
Just a couple questions.
Go ahead.
What about the laterals? Is the town going to own those, or is the owner going to own those once the project is done? How does that work with sewer?
It'd be similar to water, the approach we're currently taking, where you would need, we would be constructing as part of the initial capital construction project, and we would need easements to put them in. You have the option of not doing that if you so choose. But since your portion of the project is 50% grant funded, those laterals are 50% grant covered. Whereas if we don't include those in the project, each property owner will have to pay for the lateral fully out of pocket.
But if we did the installation, could we then turn it over to the property owner after we're done construction? I mean, that's my understanding. Most areas.
If you have a debt portion on that, which you will, through certain funding agencies, and it depends on who we end up financing the balance of the project through, if you use their funding to construct that, they'll want you to own it for at least the term of financing. Just like with the water laterals, you have to own those for at least 30 years until you pay back the loan. After that, if you so choose to turn over ownership to the private landowners, you can. But so long as you owe money on that, they want you to own it. Because EFC have a loan with you, not with the 600 EDUs out there in the district.
I wonder if that's where you
were. I'm just trying to draw correlations here between the projects.
Yeah.
About the different pieces.
Yeah.
The only thing that I need clarification on is that I feel a little bit like we got the cart before the horse here, because I don't feel like I know what we're doing as far as each individual property goes and what you've done to try to make sure that there aren't any issues with rock, or I don't want this to turn into a big over $800,000 project and all of a sudden we have to come up with more funds. This is not questioning your ability. This is, are you making sure that the numbers that you're tentatively telling us we will need for the total project, including the grant, are pretty solid. I mean, what have you done to secure that?
We use a similar method of cost estimating, the unit price method that we use for the water project.
Okay.
And we actually have more accurate information to estimate the sewer than we did when we estimated the water. So the initial estimates for water, we had no rock borings on the West Service Road. Well, now we have borings all the way up the road, courtesy of the water project.
Gotcha.
So we have a much better understanding, and that's usually the big variable, is how much bedrock. The pipe is the pipe.
Right.
Service laterals, manholes, I mean, those are pretty easy to estimate and project pricing on.
Okay.
It's the rock that tends to be the surprise at times. In this case, we have pretty good rock information.
Okay. What about vacant lots? Do we make any provisions for, not forest property where we put the water tank? Are there any provisions for a lateral, assuming it's on the other side of the road where the main is going to be? Is there any ADU type, you're responsible for a certain part of the infrastructure even if you don't attach?
Similar to the water, there would be still an EDU charge for vacant parcels.
Okay.
And again, on the water, you made that a half EDU.
Right.
You know, you would have to make a similar decision on the sewer. Would you make it a half or a quarter or something? But they would have to be charged something, as they are in a district and they are benefited by the opportunity to be able to connect. As far as constructing something for them, typically you don't put anything in for a vacant lot. A lateral has to be, especially on the sewer side, constructed very specific to how the site's going to be built out. So, you know, without any idea of what could be built there, it's kind of hard to put a sewer lateral in even partway because you don't know if you're putting it at the right depth, the right direction.
Okay. Now, will this go off the east side or the west side of the West Service Road? Do we know?
Well, we're looking at it running it up mostly on the west side. And then be on the same side as the water, we would just push them further, maintain the 10-foot minimum separation distance.
Well, that makes sense to me just from that perspective, because
yeah.
You've got more vacant lots on the west side
right.
that potential owners or builders would want
right.
to attach to.
Right.
Am I correct that if sewer was by your muscle car?
That's typically DEC mandated. So if you have money from EFC, that the money is controlled by DEC, they would make that mandate. I don't believe I've ever seen any state law that requires you to park lot. I can research that for you, but you can make that a requirement as part of your sewer use law, and sometimes DEC will mandate that if you're using their money, from the Clean Water Fund. But I don't believe I've ever seen that in town law or state law.
Okay. I'm good. Thank you.
Okay. Well, I think these one at a time. This is for that $415,000 grant that we need to accept. Am I correct? Would that be
correct,
John?
Right, yep.
So I need a motion to accept this $415,000 grant. Okay. So we need to take care of that first.
I'll make that motion.
Thank you.
I'll second it.
Thank you. Is there any questions on the grant money alone? If not, I believe I'll have a roll call vote on this also. John?
Aye.
Brian?
Aye.
Clark?
Aye.
Stephen?
Aye.
Myself, thank you. Do you need this?
Yep, we'll send that back to the Department of State.
Now, we've got two more to them. Am I correct?
Well, that's the our engineering agreement for the sewer project, amendment number one,
okay.
to scale back all our fees for just the smaller portion of the overall sewer project.
Okay, does everybody understand this one? It's basically, we had an agreement to do a much larger district. This is a scaled down district, so to speak, smaller district?
Correct.
Okay, and then we understand that one, okay?
And it'll be only the West Service Road here.
West Service Road.
Correct.
We certainly would like to have a big one.
Yeah.
And someday we hope to get that one, but.
No.
Right now, we're only talking about the West Service.
Correct.
So, this particular one does not, does it give you the, go ahead with the map and plan report, or that one?
Well, that's what I would want your authorization for. So, again, you executed the agreement 3-4 years ago originally. And at that time, you authorized us to proceed with the funding assistance services.
Yes.
And district formation assistance services. So out of that agreement, I would ask you if you would authorize also for us to do the map plan and report. And obviously, the rest of the services of the agreement, you would have to authorize for us to proceed or.
So I guess the motion needs to be written as that we're approving the map plan and report, am I correct?
Well, approve amendment number one to the engineering services agreement and authorize to proceed with the map plan and report.
Okay, as you wish. Everybody understand that one?
Yeah. So all you're doing is scaling back the original agreement?
Yep.
The West Service Road?
And saying, go ahead with the map.
We want to see the whole project, but we gotta take a baby step here and do one at a time. Okay.
And you're still applying for the.
We're still pursuing any funding that's available for the rest of the balance of the project. I mean, I think the last version, the project total budget was up to about $7 million. This carves out about $1.6 million of that, so there's about $5.4 million of the original scope project remaining that we would continue to pursue funding for.
That goes 3 or 4 years out from now, it might be even higher, so.
Yeah.
Who knows? I need a motion to approve as stated.
I'll make the motion to amend the contract for the sewer agreement with Bernier and Tarr.
Okay. Do I have a second?
Second up.
Thank you. Any questions?
So are you saying that the state's portion of this, the DOT, is like almost $500,000?
It's about a $1.6 million project on the West Service Road. We're covering about $800,000 of the cost. And then you've got the 415 grant, so there's only about 400 left or even less to borrow. That's the financial.
I was just trying to equate a value of what DOT is bringing to the project, so that.
Well, that's.
An understanding with our constituents that.
Right.
There is a significant value in that portion of what DOT is bringing to this.
They're footing about half the bill.
Yeah.
And you've got a grant to cover another quarter of it.
So.
Of course, they're assisting us with the water line, and when we do go over the water line, it's gonna be right down. They're taking their portion of what they got and helping us out with that water line coming down to Locust.
Okay, you have a motion there, do we, didn't we? Any other questions? Those in favor of amendment number one?
Aye.
Aye.
Myself, thank you. You have one other.
Well, we'll switch over to water now. Couple items to address with water. One, we have a change order to contract one. Contract one is the pipeline. The changer is a no-cost change order. And it's simply to modify four sheets of the drawings where alignment changes were required due to DOT requests or easement issues. So it's a no-cost change order to the contract. We just need to use the change order as an instrument to make these new drawings part of their contract. So we have that change order for you to approve. Again, it's no cost, just revision of four drawings.
I'll make a motion to approve the change order at no cost to the project.
Okay.
Second.
Thank you. Any questions?
Next item is, oh, sorry.
Those in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? That's also carried. Go ahead.
All right. Next item is the engineering agreement for the water project amendment that we have for you. And again, it's a no net cost change. It's just to rebalance some of the fee line items. Some of the line items came in under, some of the items have gone over, so we've just shifted the money, but it's no net increase to our contract. So that's before you to consider as well.
Anybody got any questions on that?
on this issue.
Any motion for that?
I believe so, yes.
I'll make a motion, but.
Thank you.
I guess the, I'll second it.
Any other questions? Those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? That's also carried.
Last item I have for you is EDU assignment changes. Anthony sent you an email about those summarizing the changes that we recommend. Most of those changes are due to a change in the occupancy type of the properties. Some of those EDU assignments go back quite a long ways, where we had started studying the project as far back as 11 years ago. And the occupancy type for those properties has changed. The use of the property has changed in a substantial way. And that is what most of those are about. There are a couple, I think, that are corrections, unless those are already made. Simply just clerical errors in us providing the list to the town. Some things just didn't get carried over correctly. So they're just items that need to be addressed.
John, they're in the back of your packet.
So those are our recommendations. However, obviously, final decision is yours. Weigh in and with any other considerations that you feel need to be brought in.
So we're going to accept the revisions?
Well, yes, that's okay. That's the intent. Okay, is there any questions on any one of them?
Well, just in general, what happens if all of a sudden we realize that there isn't, say, number one or number 11, the first one, all of a sudden we're seeing a huge amount of water consumption? Does that raise the EDUs?
Yeah, if they've changed their occupancy type of the building. Like if there was a building that was used as a commercial truck wash, and they cease that use and turn it over into just dry storage space, that's a change in the occupancy type of the building, and vice versa. If they change just an empty garage into a truck wash and the water usage goes up 10x, it'd be, you know, kind of a red flag that something's changed there. I mean, it's a small enough town, you kind of know what's happening in most of these properties. Mike Petro helped us considerably with, you know, what the use of each of these properties is, and he was able to help guide us and to a certain degree to come up with the EDU assignment. So, you know, Mike tends to see what's happening in the community, I think. All of you see what's happening. And if you see, you know, use change in a property, you would address that annually.
So what does this do to your total EDUs by this proposed amendment of these properties? Are we still in total?
Your net on that, did you do a plus minus net?
I did what Clark said.
We talked about this before the meeting, and my math is approximately correct. We're reducing the assigned EDUs between 26 and 27. And I was told by a source outside of this room that each EDU is approximately $113. And very quickly, the math adds up to about a reduction of almost $3,000. Assigned EDUs, 29 something.
Mm-hmm.
And I understand that this amount of money can be, as you use the word, absorbed. It doesn't have to be reassigned to other people who have already been assigned EDUs.
Yeah, I mean, you'll have to look annually once you, you know, make your annual EDU adjustments, whether someone builds a new house and you add an EDU or
The people who are already assigned EDUs for a long list. I'm assuming that this change here will not be reflected in upping the EDU assignments or the cost of their EDU assignments.
It will not change others' EDU assignment. However, annually you'll have to look at, when you're doing your budgeting process, what's our total number of EDUs this year? So you take that annual debt payment you have and you look at your EDUs. They may have gone up a couple or down a couple, but you have to divide those EDUs into the total debt. So it could go up a little bit or down a little bit each year.
But if it goes down, would it be reflective of the amount of water usage and not the adjustment we're making here?
No, the EDU charge could go up or down. Like when the, when...
But it would be based upon how much water was used, correct?
No. It'd be based on how many EDUs you have available to help pay down the debt that year.
I guess what I'm asking...
Separation between EDUs and the amount of water you...
We have this first payment that's due. Right, you're reducing, we are potentially reducing it by this many EDUs, which is a reduction in the overall monies that we're going to be bringing in for that first payment. Is there enough of a cushion that you built into the overall total EDUs to still make that payment that we need to? You follow me?
Yeah, in this first year, yeah, we both...
That's all I care about, is the first year.
Yeah, first year.
Yes. Because we're taking enough heat on the EDUs that people are being assigned at this point. And I understand it. It's just that I don't want to have to readjust anything for that first payment.
Right.
And we do have a large user, which now is a vacant lot, the new medical center.
Well, there's the hope that this will bring in business.
Right. That's, but we have a large users. I believe now they're assessing a vacant lot.
Correct.
Okay. And next year, or the year after, there's a building up there, they're overcharged accordingly.
Correct. But to your point, Steve, yeah, in this first year, there is enough cushion built in with that reduction to still make that payment.
Okay.
Yep.
Yes. So where are we here? Do you have a motion to approve these yet?
I'll make that one.
Okay, thank you. As presented to us, okay? Do I have a second?
I'll second it.
Thank you. Is there any questions on any of the EDUs?
I just want to bring up on under the number 111, on Route 11, they are agreeing to the easement, and it's not costing us anything. And we do have three weeks worth of water meters on that property, and they show it being equivalent to one EDU. Based on the conversation that I guess she had with Larry today, and she was stating that this is the peak part of her season, and during the summer it's very little water usage because I don't believe it's air conditioned, and nobody wants to be there in the summer unless you're out doing things. Also, she really feels that although it's not a great change from two EDUs to one EDU, she does feel it's a make or break deal as far as continuing the business. That's what she stated to Larry. And based on the water figures, based on her signing the easement without us having to do eminent domain, and based on the actual water usage, I would hope we could go to one EDU on that instead of two. But I mean, we do have some actual water usage there, and she does feel it's almost a make or break. I don't know if that's what she's saying. I don't know if it's how accurate that is, but I just do want to bring up what her concerns were when she was speaking to Larry and myself.
We as a group adjust this, or do we take a recommendation from?
Well, we need to justify anything that we reduce. And quite normally, we rely on engineers to qualify the reason to reduce. And most of them, we had good reasons. A couple were actual mistakes.
Half of these, I think, were mistakes.
Not half of them. A lot of them are only
1 to 1.5. Yeah, they were vacant parcels.
I did speak to the person that had a landlocked lot. She called me yesterday. And I told her it was going to be reduced to 0.1. It wasn't fully filled, but it was very acceptable of that, I believe. the only one that we've got any questions on is the one on Route 11. Do we want to reduce the one?
Well, we have the water figures. I mean, it's not just...
They put a meter in for three, I believe, 3 weeks of readings. Okay. And she came in slightly under what one household would normally use. Am I correct in those terms?
Yeah.
Okay. We've got to be careful here because a whole lot of people may want meters on their houses and they're going to get meters. Okay, everybody's going to get a meter eventually.
And hopefully it'll make everything more accurate.
Yeah. Well, I think it's a requirement that everybody has a meter. Okay.
Just like that, I'm okay with this because I know the meters are going to tell us what the consumption would be. And at any point during the test phase, someone could make sure they're not consuming...
We understand that.
...an excessive amount of water. So over time, next year, we see that there's an equivalent of 5 EDUs, and it goes back up to 5 EDUs because it's based on the consumption of that property, right?
Yeah, the methodology...
Of a property, not...
Right. The methodology is to assign an EDU for the capacity of usage for that type of property. So I use the example of a restaurant. If we assign 4 EDUs to a restaurant, based on our standard methodology of doing it, that's industry-wide standard, and the owner reduces reduces their business. Let's say they were serving lunches and dinners, and then they decide we're only going to serve dinners, and their water usage goes down. We shouldn't reduce their EDUs, because the capacity of the restaurant is to serve lunches and dinners. So when they want to reduce to just dinners and ask for a reduction of their EDUs because they're using less water, we don't get to reduce the size of the water plant. We don't get to reduce the size of the water tank. We don't get to reduce the size of the water pipes in the ground or the debt that we have on all of that stuff that was designed and built to serve their maximum capacity. So once that infrastructure is built and we have debt on it at a capacity necessary to serve all the properties as they were being used when it was built. Now it's a different story if they tear that restaurant down or if they gut the restaurant and make it a single family home. They completely change the occupancy type. So, you know, we like to try to understand, so what's the maximum capacity of water usage there? The owner at that property in question made some good points. This is my maximum occupancy usage at this point. You know, this is my busiest time of year. This is the most customers I'm going to get. And this is it. You know, this is my lunch and dinner type of comparison to a restaurant. Okay. So she made some valid points. Again, there's some gray area in this. And, you know, ultimately, it's your decision.
So, the meter suggested what's shown here, or the meter suggested one EDU?
The meter usage would be typical of what one EDU is.
For a 3 week period.
For that, which is a very small snapshot in time. But, again, it is, as she states, her busiest time of the year.
A lot of people do bring bottled water, and mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I know that for a fact that people tend to bring to the bathroom, so it's probably the biggest. But, I she seems to feel it's a make or break thing. There's a possibility she wants to turn it into self-storage if she can't afford to continue in the business. And if that did happen, then we'd go from 2 to probably half a year. So.
Should she argue for a half?
No. If she changed the use,
okay.
Similar to what Matt was saying, that instead of going down to 1, you'd go down to half a year. I'm just throwing this out, but, you know, she seems to feel that it definitely would affect her business enough if that close to having a problem that the extra EDU is a make or break thing, and if it does break her, she's just gonna say the heck with it, turn it into self-storage. I mean, it's a lot less work, I mean, I don't know if it's more money or not, but it's a hell of a lot less work than running a gym. I'm just pointing these things that were brought out, and, you know, Matt's thought towards, and
we do have another piece of property with meter on it too, just to be aware of that, okay?
I would encourage you to try to take an approach to this, or if you're gonna adjust it for reasons that are very consistent, but with the reasons on the other properties, and that it's based on, you know, the maximum capacity for that property. Otherwise, the more consistent you are in that approach, the more defendable your decisions will be. If you start making decisions on EDU adjustments based on individual hardships, you could open up a can of worms. So if you're going to adjust this one, I think you need, in my opinion, do it on the rationale that if you're going to reduce it to one EDU, do it with the rationale that that is equivalent to the maximum capacity water usage for that property.
Right.
Not for hardship reasons. I would caution you on that, because
right, that's a good point.
Yeah.
But I
right now I see the number five originally, and then underneath there's an X. What's your recommendation on that X?
In the conversation today, we already reduced it from 5 to 2.
Oh, right. When we had sent that, we hadn't received the water usage, the meter readings yet.
Okay.
When we had sent that.
So
and then Anthony sent the follow-on.
So in place of the X, your recommendation is?
Our recommendation that we had sent you via email was 2.
Okay.
But during discussion today, the property owner did make some valid points for you to consider 1. Again, it's
I'm asking
right there.
Your recommendation. Go on.
I think he's saying there's a lot of gray area here. It's how do you want to go? I mean, we've gone back and forth on how you assign EDUs, and
mm-hmm.
You know, probably the best is the meters, because we're going to be adjusting them all in the future.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, everybody's going to be looked at, and there's going to be adjustments. And I assume most of it's going to be done on the water meter usage. We're going to use that to get an idea. I mean, it may not be.
It helps you dial in.
It helps you dial it in.
But Global Fitness, isn't that on a well?
It is now. Yeah, it's on a well now. But they got a meter on that well.
Mm-hmm.
Our meter.
Yeah. And they do have.
Well, what I'm saying is, being on a well, we'll have access down to the water you use for the future. So I think we should be on the goal with Coop says. I think we should be very careful with this.
I bring it to everybody's attention. That's all I you know. It is a gray area. It's, you know.
I think if we start individually looking at these, and we as a group start adjusting without their support or recommendation, I think we're walking on thin ice.
Yeah. I don't disagree, but it's also got to be, you know, we are going to be making adjustments
mm-hmm.
as we go. It's just, it's got to be fine-tuned.
Yeah, I mean, my recommendation of 2 was based on the fact that they still have those showers. They have, theoretically, they would have the capacity of being at least 2 EDUs. What the property owner has pointed out is that they could have 20 more showers there. They wouldn't use any more water. She's at her maximum capacity of customers for what, you know, the demographics here are gonna produce. So she said, you know, based on what she argued, again, she could have 20 more pieces of exercise equipment and 20 more showers, and there still wouldn't be any more water used there. And there's other things driving what her maximum water usage is going to be, and it's what we're seeing through the meter right now.
penciling in too. It's not now, this is just developed today. If we need to reduce it, we need to do that this evening, I believe.
You know, one shot if you can.
Whatever the lower board is.
I'm trying to do what I believe is fair. You know, and if it goes to two, it's not unfair. If it goes to one, it's not unfair. It's what.
Do you think, we should set them?
Well.
Just make a determination, or should we?
I would like to go with one. But I'd like to do the whole list at once. I think she put up a good enough case for one EDU to justify us lowering it from two to one in the recommendation. You know, she made some good points, but there's also points to be made for keeping it. It's just, personally, I think it'd be more fair. We also have a water meter next door too. And why, what's the point of having that water meter if we're not gonna do anything with it? I'm throwing this out. It's not, I'm not trying to.
I see it both ways.
Yeah, I do too.
I really like Matt's analogy of the cost of the infrastructure of the project and how that doesn't change. Somehow we have to be consistent on how we determine the EDUs, the capacity description or dialogue shows consistency. If you're telling me, and this is just my opinion, that you feel that capacity is one based on what you, then I'm okay. Because somebody else comes in and says, well, you lower theirs to one, I want mine to be one. How are we gonna stand firm if we're not consistent?
But we do have 3 weeks worth of water usage. And it is the heat season, so to speak, cold. Our wonderful spring has been cold and been beneficial to somebody like that. In the summer, there's very little usage. I mean, you can drive by. I mean, I drive by there every day at different times, like based on the cars in the parking lot, you make some assumptions. As most businesses, you can't. You know, if there's two cars, it's kind of hard to say they're using a lot of water. If it's 25, different story. You know, you do have a basis so far. Again,
it's the world board.
But are you looking for a motion to accept this
what?
As presented, or are you looking to amend it? Or?
We don't have a motion yet, really. No. There's two ways to make a motion. Okay. Make a motion to accept it as presented, or accept it with one change of amendment, one amendment, from two to one. Whatever the motion is, we'll act on it. Anyway, we need to act on it one way or another.
I'll make the motion that we adopt the EDU count change with the only change on the paper presented is going to one for global segment.
Is there a second to that motion? Without a second, I don't have a motion. So I need a motion to accept as presented, if I could.
I'll make that motion as presented.
Does everybody understand the motion? You made the motion. I need to decide. You got a second on that?
No. Don't second for that either.
Exactly.
What do you guys want to do? Come on. You can't hide over there.
No,
it's not.
I didn't get a second
to apply. Let's talk about it. Like, if we're not getting clarity on it.
The first motion, I did not get a second. I can't act on that.
Right.
The second motion, I second. The original.
What do you think, Ken?
It's a very tough call, and I didn't know she was coming today. I would like to talk to her myself, but.
She didn't come in.
I thought she was coming.
She talked. I called her. Larry called her. In fact, I asked her to come in to sign the easement. She said, no, somebody will have to come to her place. It has to be a notary. She just can't get away the other day. I have a motion to approve the list as presented tonight. That particular one being two units, two EDUs.
I'll second that motion.
Thank you.
And just to clarify, it's instead of the X, it's two.
Yes.
On number 111.
I understand that.
I mean, just to make sure that.
Property number 111.
Because it is an X.
Yes. Okay, two. Okay. Let's have a roll call vote then. This is a pretty important issue, John.
Yeah, aye.
Brian?
Aye.
Bart?
Aye.
Stephen?
Aye.
Aye, Melissa, thank you. What else you got for us, sir?
That's it. I think we've touched on most everything, but just to recap quick on the status of the water project. As you know, the tanks are nearly finished, mostly just site restoration.
Okay, good.
And
they're going to have to wait to finish the project to do the energy pressure testing. Right?
Correct.
So even
disinfection, yep.
So even when the tank's complete, we can't finish it until we bring it.
Correct. We'll have to leave the contract open until the pipeline work's done and the plant work's done so that we can actually fill the higher tank. But that work is 95% complete on the tanks. The pipeline project contract, as you know, we had a pre-con since your last board meeting. Gave the contractor notice to proceed to begin work. Probably seen materials arrive on site, and they will be progressing in earnest in the next week or two with the construction of the pipeline. Last is the...
Is the ground thawed?
I don't know if you ever had frost. I think Mike Jolliker told us he was digging a month ago and there was almost no frost a month ago. Yeah. And then last is the treatment plant, which is at Department of Health for approval. Depending on how long it may take to review that, hopefully we'll be able to get that out the bid in May. Begin construction on that this summer.
When will they start, Matt, with the putting the pipe in? Do you know?
They provided us their schedule, obviously subject to change. One thing in particular we've asked them to begin with is the directional drill underneath the river in the village. Right now, there's only one line of connection from the west side of the village to the east side, and that is the asbestos water main that we're going to replace. So if there's a problem in that replacement process, there's no way to get water from one side of the village to the other. So it was actually a good point brought up by the village that maybe we should do that directional drill under the river to provide another link from the west to the east side of the village so that if there's a problem in replacing that asbestos pipe, there's still another way to get water back and forth. So that's what they're going to begin with. As far as the rest of the pipeline, you probably looked at that recently.
Yeah, they'll go from there to the railroad bed, that replacement, and then from West Service Road on the southern end, and we'll go north. This is the latest schedule.
Okay. And as we touched on with the budget at this point, still looks good. I mean, the tank bids came in good, the pipe bids came in good, and we've got a placeholder for the treatment plant with still contingency remaining. That's all I have for this evening, unless you have any questions.
Do we know where to find you?
Yeah.
Yes, we need the GSA contract, and you thought we might ask the village.
Yeah, we talked to Greg before that meeting.
It's an old contract. It hasn't been signed. It's old.
Yeah, I know, I guess.
And it's one page.
Right,
yeah.
It's one page.
I know.
But it had to be old. It'd be 40 pages today.
It probably
say the same thing.
But
I'll look for tomorrow.
The lawyers seem to feel it would be a good starting point.
Would it be premature for me to stop by and salt on the water softener?
A little bit.
Okay,
the nano filtration's not in there.
Not that, it's okay.
What's the other part? primary election next Tuesday here for all town residents. I believe there has been only one side place here.
Monday?
Next Tuesday, 19th.
The 19th?
I believe it's, it says you're, it's 12 to 9 anyways. Okay? Just for information. On the desk tonight, you had your dog control officer report.
There was another one in that folder.
Yes, it's a shorter one in that folder.
I was very pleased to see that, Ross's point, on the 27th, that, John Cooper was able to get his dog back.
Who was it?
Just John Cooper.
He's different John Cooper.
Oh, not John Cooper Junior.
John Cooper Senior.
This is John Cooper.
Anyways, we need to approve the town clerk's monthly report.
I have a motion to approve the town clerk's monthly report.
Can I have a second?
Second.
Any questions? Those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Pre-bill report, you have those, that's for the, water bills going out, that's strictly for information. There's only board appeals, minutes, strictly for information. The real property office is here every Thursday, every month, this month, April 7th, 14th, 21st, and 28th. Okay, that's pretty.
And people can call.
Oh, people can call in. And sometimes they're here on Mondays and Fridays, but they're always here on Thursdays, okay? And you have your second, dog catcher, dog control officer report. Did you know, the American Water Works Association, Water Week, May 1st through 7th, that's strictly for information from the county health department. We did have a boil water order. I understand that sample was taken today, that should be left in the unit building, at this building all day now. Okay. We had a valve that needed fixing on our system out the garage. Got a letter from the Clinton County Health Department concerning residents and their families, the goals, public information for residents over the next 2 months. Okay. Any questions, give a call on that one. The permanent board of directors ballot. I don't normally roll those. The permanent payroll audit. Strictly for information. Gives you all the salaries and everybody works here. That's how our rate is determined. We also got a letter from in the Health and Safety Act from PERMA to our training. Neymar, strictly information to get into their annual meeting. Casella, we did the Casella Daily Water CBU account, we did that already. The regulations and permits for the landfill. Tells you we have to pay a $45 processing fee for any trucks that go in and out of there. So once a year fee. You get, I believe Alan does subscribe to that. He uses it sometimes. It talks about the mandatory that all vehicles start to those violators of the state law will be reported to local park law enforcement agency. Relief Conference in July, Saratoga. First time I ever got that one. I won't go into that either. Superintendent Highways report, I think I got the report probably, is that we are doing site work for our new salt storage shed. That's progressing fairly well. The engineers took a look at the site this afternoon, also recommendations. We do have some ledge out there that needs blasting. Trying to get a handle on that.
So we'll still be able to qualify for that grant?
Oh, yes. Without the grant, we don't have a salt shed.
Right, right.
If we all donate our salaries, it's still gonna be enough.
Is there any movement on the purchase of the property the sand will come from?
Pardon?
The property that we were planning to purchase, those sand pits?
Yes. I did go down to Plasver, so go and sign those papers for that property. The last, I heard last week, Thursday or Friday, that the attorney for the other party that we're buying from is on vacation.
The assessment was?
Yeah, assessed value was.
Is accurate?
Yes, it was slightly above what we're paying for it, okay? So that was, okay. I got a letter from a concerned resident. I don't know where to go with this one. Eileen Morrison reside at 1615 Ridge Road. Requested the water utilities belonging to my, not belonging to myself, to be removed from my property. These utilities consist of a water shut off and meter pit belonging to Daniel Bishard, his next door neighbor. I'm asking this for the following reasons, so that I do not have to be one to maintain and mow and trimming around the utilities. Repair or changes when needed on my land will not be disturbed. If I were to sell, the future owner should not have the responsibility for upkeep of these utilities. Now, I can only tell you what I know, that this water system on the Ridge Road was put in mid-90s sometimes. Wyeth did that project, and for some unimportant reason, I had no clue why, they used one meter pit for two different houses.
No, 2 meter pits there.
Pardon?
2 meter pits there.
There's 2 meter pits?
Yeah, they only get that far.
Then we, well, okay, the second one should not be where it is, they might.
Apparently, the way you did, I didn't realize that was a lady's property, that there is a meter pit there.
Okay.
Were there meters at the time?
I have no clue.
Well, we would have moved there at the time anyway, so.
Well, he's gonna go to the property.
You'd have to look at the deeds.
Yeah, I mean, the phone company came, the electric company came after the power outage, and I had to, you know, sign easements, and you go back in the deeds, it's there in perpetuity. The easement, once it's there, it's there. So, that would be my.
So just to simplify it for me now, Mr. Morrison's saying that Mr. Bishard's water line is on his property?
It's meter pit. Now, that came about, I have no clue, and he wants to revoke.
Have we verified that it is, or do we not know if we can verify?
Well, we don't know, actually, I don't know where the property line would be. First, they'd have to mark out the property. Somebody just had a survey, I think, that Mr. Bishard had a survey. There must be some flags or something there, but some. But if we don't replace the meters anyway, maybe we can have Mike move it over.
We'd have to move the whole meter pit up closer to.
Yeah. Bring it over, I mean, after they get up moving over, but the only thing is I'll say, like, is there something in either deed that says it's there, and we don't know. This all started with the zoning board, or zoning board, but it's not even over the property line. I understand from Mickey that Mr. Bishard had a survey, and his garage is only a foot off the line, and that was his bad blood there, if you want to call it that. So I don't know if that's a, is that the town's problem? Probably better ask the, our
they have the information right there, and it's a fairly current process.
Well, our assessors know that, they have that one for that.
Or I don't know.
Not seen.
The real property match.
Yeah. Tim's really good with it and was out, but I don't know if he had.
I think check into it.
Okay, they're asking him through Thursday, so he is really good at what he does.
Yeah.
Okay, I will do that, start that process, see where it goes.
And otherwise, is just the meters that need to be replaced in the water system, that's right. So if something happens, are we planning on doing any laterals there or?
No, that's near.
So it would be cheaper if there is an easement for the town. All right.
I don't know where to go now, I'll look into it, so I'll.
Yeah, well, Tim, if Tim can't tell us, John can.
I wouldn't commit to anything until you research it, so.
Yeah.
I will not commit to anything, I'll check with everybody on that one. We paid the bills, I have nothing else, I do have one item for executive session, legal matter. If nobody else has anything for the board meeting?
I just wanted to say, I talked to Tim and they researched a little bit of tax exemption for solar projects. And even though they are tax exempt, there is a 15-year maximum on it. So after 15 years, we will be getting full taxation on that. There is a time limit. I mean, we.
Well, it's 5 years because the life expectancy is only 20, so.
Well, I just point that out, that's a little sliver.
It is, you're right.
And they do pay all ad valorem taxes if they're in the water district or sewer and EMS and fire protection. They do, so he did make.
Well, that's good.
He ran a copy of the chart if anybody wants to see it, but 50, you know, it's better than nothing, even if we only get.
Oh, that's good.
And I just have the question, you were getting the EMS report?
Yeah, I was going to look at it. Did you get one last month? I haven't got one this month. Well, I don't believe we asked for it a month and a half quarterly, did we?
Well, no, we asked for it a month. We're getting it.
They make it.
More than quarterly.
I think they generate it monthly.
Okay, I'll check on that.
Well, it's just, it was good information.
No.
Really good information, the way they have.
You should have.
Not a problem, I shouldn't be a problem.
Yeah.
Make a motion to adjourn.
Oh, you don't?
No, I make a motion to go into executive session.
I tried.
Second.
Oh, in favor?
Aye.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Yeah, happy birthday.
Thank you very much.